All right. How many people do we have now? Oh, we have 31. That's great. All right. Thank you so much. Let me take attendance real quick and then we start our section for today. You see me? Okay, let me see for 31 people. All right, thank you so much. Okay, let's continue on this one. For the partial derivatives, you can see it's okay, hold on. I see you. All right, hold on. Hey, how can I see you guys? Where are you? Is that in the room? Okay, that's fine. All right, so let's see this one, the idea for, when I'm gonna be able to do this. Okay, whatever. All right, for partial derivatives, you're gonna see the function will be at least, you know, two variables. The first one, like for this one, will be f of x and y. So when you see this, you have to expect that when we talk about derivatives, you need to use partial derivatives. The regular one won't work for here. For example, if you take derivative with respect to x, but your function contains two variables, x and y. So in this case, you see, the independent variable that we consider right now is just x variable alone. Therefore, you need to take y as a constant. So probably you just plug in any y, you know, you replace it with y naught. Similarly, if you take derivative with respect to y, you take x as a constant. It seems like we take this function as a function of y only. So let's see this definition. So for the definition here, this one, remember, usually when you take the limit, you have limit of f x plus h minus fx or divided by h, and you take the limit h goes to zero. But now it depends if you use f sub x or f sub y. That means you're going to take partial derivative of f with respect to x or y. It depends, right? And you can see here, if the function in the front and the back use exactly the same y naught, that means we fix y naught. So y naught just constant, nothing changed about this variable. But x, you see that? You have x naught plus delta x, and here will be just x naught, and here will be delta x, and then you take delta x goes to zero. Why do we need to talk about this one? Just in case, if you have the test that asks you to find partial derivative by using the definition, you have to use this one to show me. The other way to say that, you can use this formula. F sub x equal to limit of f x plus delta x y minus f x y, or divided by delta x when delta x goes to zero. Similarly for f sub y, you see that? And in case that you let z equal to f of x, y, and I ask you to find f sub x or f sub y, it's exactly the same thing that you find c sub x and c sub y, because c is the same function as f. And if I want you to evaluate the partial derivative of this function at a certain point, let's say x naught, y naught, So in this case, you see, we just follow the symbol here and you just calculate the partial derivative. After that, you just plug in the point that's the problem asks you to evaluate at. You see, at the point x naught, y naught later. Okay, and after we talk about this, so let's, before we go back to our document, last time I remember we finished up something about chain rule, right? Okay, let's switch off to do some exercise about this one. Okay, I would like you to find so let's give a try here. No, it's not something within this different class. All right, let me do this real quick. I don't want to see the participant list. I just want to keep the chat box and okay, minimize this one. All right. So let's give a try. Okay, I just want to know, like, everyone, you know how to do the problem together. For example, this one gonna be the part of partial derivative. Okay, this one will be partial derivatives. For example, let's find this. I would like you to find f sub x of 1, 3 and f sub y of 1, 3 as well. For what? For the function f of x and y equal to 2x cubed y squared plus 2y plus 4x. All right, let's try the first example. Whoever get the solution, please type on the chat screen f sub x and f sub y. Because right now we just evaluate the partial derivative at a certain point. Therefore, the answer supposed to be just a number, right? So how are we gonna do that? So, solution. You need to find f sub x first. Agree? So you find f sub x of x, y. So now I just take y as a constant. So the first term right here, I just have 6x squared and y squared. And in terms of y is a constant, so it will be 0. And the last term will be 4. You see that? Therefore, f sub x of 1, 3, wherever be x, I just plug in 1. 6 times 1 square times what? 3 square plus 4. 9 times 6, 54 plus 4. The answer will be 58. You see that? How about f sub y? F sub y of x, y would be what? F sub y of x, y is equal to, now from this function, you see, from the original function here, we have to take what? Take x as a constant. Therefore, this group gonna be the constant. So we have 2y, right? So 2y times 2 will be 4. Now we have 4x cubed y. And then the second term here we have plus 2 and take x as a constant. So we have 0. And now it's time to plug in. Therefore, f sub y of 1, 3 is equal to, you plug in x with 1, 4 times 1 cubed times 3 plus 2, it's 12 plus 2. The answer for this one is gonna be 14. See that? Pretty simple, right? Or if you don't like this way, okay? Suppose you don't like this way. Somebody, you know, may think like this. Let's fix y equal to 3, okay? Let's fix y equal to 3 to find f sub x at 1, 3. How are we gonna do that? So recall, in this case, you can recall f of xy equal to what? F of xy is 2x cubed y square plus 2y plus 4x. Therefore, if you want to find f sub x of xy, but now you need to fix y, you see? This is going to be 3, okay? And if this number is 3, how are we going to deal with the other side? This one is just like, you have to do the regular derivative, right, of this function. So it's going to be 2x cubed, and here it's going to be 3 squared. After that, plus 2 times what? Times 3, fixed. And after that, gonna plus 4x. You see that? And if you simplify this form, you're going to have d by dx of what? 9 times 2, 18x cubed, plus 6 and plus 4x. You see that? Okay, so in this case, how are we gonna get it? All right, so this one, you see you multiply 3, right? You take derivative, you're gonna get 54x squared, and this one will be 0 and plus 4. And now it's time to calculate. Therefore, f sub x of 1, 3 is 54 times 1 plus 4, exactly 58, you see? So we actually get the same solution. See that? All right. Okay. That's it. Okay, let's give a try some more example. Next example, I would like you to find dc by dx and dc by dy if given z is a function of x to the fourth times sine of xy cubed. All right. Oops, can you hear me? I'm not sure. I open up like two windows, so sometimes I might like mute that microphone and open this one. So not sure about that. Oh, okay. Panya, like I'm hearing nothing on this side. Panya, can you hear me now? All right. Thank you. Okay, how about this example? Based on this one, can you see right now C is a function of what? X and Y. Therefore, if you want to find F sub X, C sub X is the same thing as F sub X. Usually, when you see this form, it's just like the function of F of X and Y, same thing. Therefore, when you find this one, it's the same thing as partial derivative of C with respect to X. And when you find it, what you're gonna get, and Z sub Y is F sub Y and dC by dy. Okay, let's work on it. Give a try, maybe 1 minute. What's gonna be the answer for the first one? So to do this, you see, you take derivative with respect to X, right? So you take Y as a constant. Even though Y is a constant, we still have two functions. The first one will be X to the fourth, and the other one will be sine of this X variable. So you need to use what? Product rule. By the product rule, so I take this one as a U, and sine here will be V. So U dV plus V dU, what you're gonna get? You're gonna have U X to the fourth dV. So we have constant term here when you take a chain rule, right? So we get Y cubed cosine XY cubed, all right? U dV plus what? Plus V dU, where's your V? U dV plus V, V is a sine function. And you have to take derivative of X to the fourth. So we have plus 4X cubed, and keep sine the same. Here we go, done. How about the bottom one? C sub Y, so we take X as a constant. So X a constant. So we have only one function, right? Okay, keep X to the fourth. And here, derivative of sine, we get cosine. And you have to take derivative inside here with respect to Y. So we have 3XY square. And times cosine XY cubed. Done. Okay, so this is gonna be some example of the partial derivatives. All right, so next one, let's talk about rates of change and slope. Okay, let's see this one. Okay, make sure I open up this one. All right. The next one. So now we done with the partial derivatives. Next one is going to be rate of change and slope. Okay, let's see how they explain here. Geometrically, f sub x at the point x naught y naught can be viewed as the slope of the tangent line to the curve z1. And f sub y, okay, similarly, can be viewed as the slope. Okay, just the same idea. So when you take derivative, the first derivative usually implies to the what's that implies to the slope, right? So to do that, let's see this picture. So if you have the curve and you want to find the slope f sub x at a point x naught y naught, okay, somebody say not finish. Okay, we're gonna come back on the writing page soon. Just get some idea here first. Okay, so let's see here. If you notice, this one gonna be what? The slope that's parallel to the x-axis for f sub x. And f sub y kind of like parallel to the y-axis. So from here, we can look at f sub x as a slope of a surface in the x direction at point x naught y naught, and y f sub y is a slope of surface in the y direction at x naught y naught. Okay, just want you to see the picture. Usually we have only like two dimensional, right? And when we find the slope, okay, you have the curve, you have the point, you find the slope, that's it. But now you have to look at it as a slope in some direction. But very easy, you see f sub y will be in the x direction, f sub x in the x direction, and f sub y will be in the y direction. Let's move on to higher partial derivative just a little bit. It's something very, a little bit different from what we discussed last term. Remember, when you have f x y, you see f sub x y, usually in the previous note we take derivative with respect to y first and then x, you see. But from this book, they take derivative with respect to x first and then y. So I would like to choose one of them. How about we follow this one? So if you have f sub xx, that means you take partial derivative of this function with respect to x twice. Similarly, as f sub y, you take partial derivative with respect to y twice. But then when we talk about f sub xy and f sub yx, okay, let's make it clear. Let's take derivative with respect to the variable that close to f first. For example, this one x is pretty close to f, so we take derivative with respect to x first and then y later. Similarly, this one we have y close to f, so take partial derivative with respect to y first, then x later. And this one is called the mixed second order partial derivatives, or the mixed second partial. Okay, before we move on to the differentiability, let's do some example on this. Okay. All right. Sorry if you haven't finished this one. Okay, how about next example? Let's talk about example in the rate of change and slope a little bit. Okay, that's the previous example. So this one, whoa, not now. All right. Okay, so this gonna be example for rates of change and slope. Okay. Let's see example. If I let fxy equal to this function x squared y plus 5y cubed, Alright, so now we have this function, fxy equal to x squared y plus 5y cubed. Okay, I have the first question. I would like you find the slope of the surface. Find the slope of the surface. Z, this function, right? Equal to f of x and y. Okay. In the x direction. Okay, in the x direction at the point, let's say 1 and negative 2. How are we going to do that? Actually, the meaning of this is just what? F sub x, right? So the solution for this one, for this part, the solution is going to be f sub x. You need to find f sub x of x and y, which is what? Partial derivative of f with respect to x, which is what? 2. So now you take y as a constant, so this term will be 0. So we have 2xy plus 0. So at the end, you have only 2xy. Once you have this, therefore, the slope for this function in the x direction would be f sub x at 1, negative 2 is equal to what? Is equal to 2 times 1 times minus 2. So it's minus 4. So this will be answer. What does it mean when we say it's equal to negative 4? It means that the meaning is z, right? This function is decreasing at the rate of 4 units. Okay, this one means like of 4 units. 4 units per what? Per unit increase in x. Yeah, so this is going to be the meaning of that. So if I want you to find the slope, so the answer will be negative 4. And the meaning is z is decreasing at the rate of 4 units per unit increase in x. Similarly, if I change to part 2, how about part 2? It's part 1. And part 2, asking pretty much the same. So I ask you, find the slope of the surface. Z equal to fxy. But now in the y direction at the point, same point, 1 minus 2. How are we going to do that? So now I'm asking you to find what? Asking you to find f sub y. Of xy. Or partial derivative of f with respect to y. Which is what? Now, as a function right here, you take x as a constant. So the first term, you just have x squared pop up. And the second term, you have 15y squared. All right. And then do the calculation for f sub y at 1 minus 2. So we have 1 square plus 15 times minus 2 square. So it's what? 4, 60, 61. See? And the explanation for here, which means C is increasing. At the rate of 61 units per unit increase in Y. Here we go. So this is gonna be example of how we apply the partial derivatives, you know? Not bad, right? Okay, and before we move on to what's that, the questions about higher order of partial derivatives. Actually, we can apply, you know, the partial derivative to implicit partial differentiation. Have you heard about that? Okay, next one is going to be implicit. Partial differentiation.